Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is EXO coming at you here from up north, enjoying all the nice weather we've been having. Spring has officially sprung, and we've been loving it up here. All the great weather. Just got ourselves back from a show yesterday down in New Hampshire. In fact, I did a little something different, though. Instead of bringing the camera and just focusing all on videos, I wanted to focus on having a good time, hanging out with friends and stuff like that. So I put the camera aside for a little bit and just focused on giving some nice bass demos and having some good old-fashioned back-to-the-roots fun. It was really great. Gave out some awesome bass demos, great hair tricks, got some tap-outs on film, and it's definitely opened up with the extra amps, which I do not believe you guys have seen, so I'm not gonna deprive you of that. Freaking hell, right? Here's what it came out to be looking like. Got my sweatshirt over there, but pretty damn spiffy, guys. I got some little foam inserts right here to make sure that the batteries don't rub up against the metal there. But overall, really liking the way it came together. These 3500s, man, are power horses. Never get warm on me, just freaking dailying it all the time. In fact, I was giving demos for damn near like 20, 25 minutes straight sometimes. The only problem I was having was the little bit of a tracking issue on my belt there. My tensioner is failing, so I've been doing, you know, little bits and pieces to try to fix that, but I finally found out a way to fix it, so I'm gonna do a little bit of a brace. I'll kind of show you what I'm working with. I'm still able to demo at full tilt, and I wasn't really having problems with breaking anything, but I was just having a little bit of flex going on up here after the tensioner failed. Right there, that little tensioner right there needs to be replaced and put a little bracket on, so I gotta hold the hood here. But everything held up great. My voltage friggin' never dipped below like 14.5 at full tilt. Awesome testament to our raggy alternators right there. I just gotta get the bracket a little bit more situated because it is 3 years old. So, you know, problems always arise in this kind of stuff, especially when you got, you know, 618s moving as much shit as it was moving. Oh yeah, it took first place. It was a 59.9. Pretty cool. I've never done that style of competition, so it was my first time. Just chucked those dust caps on there. I was having a trouble with them sticking. Used a little bit of acetone like David recommended, and it went on there fairly easy. Did a little bit of siliconing. I know it doesn't look the greatest, but it actually sounds a lot better. I tried to Gorilla Glue this in there, but it just snapped the glue. Labeled my doors so now I can remember which is which. We did a lot of doors open demos, a lot of hot seats the other day. Sounded fucking awesome. The crescendo mids and highs have really, really just come alive. I think I've already mentioned that with the new amps. Everybody was really impressed with the sound of them. And just overall, really great time yesterday. One of the things I really want to stress, though, is that, like, how much I love bass. And it's not always just about making videos. So, like, yesterday was just a great reminder of how much I really love this sport and why I do it. You know, breaking shit is always fun, but it's really the smiles on people's faces that keep you inspired to do this, because it brings joy to a lot of people, not only just myself. Having some problems with the ADPRS, I got a glare on my camera right now. I'll basically explain to you what happened. This little area up here flexes a whole lot, and the first day I broke off my knob so much so that I couldn't even change the volume anymore. I couldn't change the track anymore. This whole kind of little, this little potentiometer stopped working, as well as these little rocker switches. So that was kind of frustrating. I had to reset and take apart this whole thing to get it to go, and then I started having problems with the pin connectors on this. It shuts off every single time I play a song. The ADPRS is awesome with functionality, but I have to say it's built really cheaply. I've already broken like 3 or 4 things on it. I have to reset it every single bass demo, and the pins just don't want to cooperate. So the display totally shuts off, and you can no longer see what you're playing or turn the volume up or change the song. So what's next on the menu, guys? I got to, yesterday the 59.9 was with my 28 hertz ports. I forgot to tell you that. I was going to take out my ports, but it takes about 5 to 10 minutes to take them out, and then it takes about 20 to 30 minutes to put them back in because I forgot my lock washers. As you can see, one of them fell out right there. But it sounds fucking amazing, guys. This shit, it plays all the way up to 80 hertz, and it will play all the way down to fucking 20 or below. I haven't really tested it with like the teens or anything like that, but it very, very dynamic builds. I'm so fucking happy with it. One thing I didn't mention, I went around and did the good old EXO sealing on everything, just siliconed everything up to make sure it's no air leaks or water leaks, everything like that. Well, sometimes when you're rolling down the road and you're getting all that flex going, droplets of water can get in there, and I don't want my amps to even see a little bit of it. And I also forgot to mention, I have my 45s. I cut some 45s for the inside of my box. I just haven't put them in yet. I resined them all up. I'm peaking at 32 on the dash sealed, and I'm not sure what I'm peaking at with the door open. The tool makers are looking great, guys. I love how he added that little made in the USA thing. Really, really decent there. Little C box from Scott Bowman. Just giving you guys a little update on the system there. I finally added the other two amps, so my last two ports are finally taken up. Check it out, guys. My first little, I've never had anything PSI. It's my first little thing from them. Pretty damn cool, huh? I got some carnage on my lens from flexing the damn camera with some concrete. I got a video of that, but fuck, I didn't realize that my lens was kind of just like rubbing all over it. But yeah, yesterday at the show, someone kept one of the spare pieces of my belt, and I gave it to him, and he posted a picture. He's like, he's gonna make millions. That's pretty funny. But yeah, guys, this is pretty much it. I added the grounds, added more power wire, amps, got the 45s, freaking siliconed up everything to make sure it doesn't fall off. You know, going down the highway yesterday, holy shit, this thing almost came off. This thing pops up so far. It goes up like an inch or two higher than that right there. And I damn near almost lost my side view mirror going freaking 65 miles an hour. And also, I didn't mention this little thing right here, my brake fluid. Holy shit. I think DJ Incline has a video of this. If it wasn't for these steel braided lines, this thing would break because it moves damn near 2 inches from top to bottom. That's why you see all this spewedness everywhere. Holy hell. I'll have to get a hold of Andy. Maybe he'll, you know, I'll try to link that up. But I don't think he's posted any videos yet. But holy shit. I wish I got that on video, that's one thing. You know, holy crap, this was just insane. I'm searching for the tenths. Maybe I'll, you know, angle up these a little more to get that extra little tenth. But before, let me give you a little brief explanation on the amplifiers, on the impedance that I was running at last time. You know, these were running at like 0.3 with all four amps. So I was getting a really good amount of power after rise from those four. So when I added the extra two, I jumped up. Maybe next year we can get like a dual 0.7s or something like that. That would be nice, because then after rise I'd be a little bit better than what I am right now. Even those little, even tenths, you know, when you're talking about, you know, impedance this low, you know, even tenths make a big difference. I'm gonna do another little extra brace right here because I had a little bit, just a tiny bit of movement. I mean, these things are solid as hell, but I gotta go over there into the side trim panel, because that's why I didn't do it in the first place, because it was a trim panel. But we'll figure it out, guys. Batteries are going awesome. The Crescendo Logics are working great. All right, guys, I think I'm gonna wind down this update video. I just wanted to, you know, let you guys know about everything, give you one little look at what I've got next on the list for today. I'm gonna go down to Parts Express. Blah, holy fuck, I can't speak. I'm gonna go down the Tractor Supply and get some stock, some bar stock, and try to cut a little brace for this, see what we can do. But I'm really happy with the voltage. It's fucking awesome. It's just ungodly amounts of fucking flex. Really crazy. My buddy Marcos posted a video. I might even just throw up a quick clip, but holy fuck, it was insane. It was insane, guys. So until the next video, always, guys, huge thanks for watching the videos. It means a lot to me. Like, going to that show. Oh, was I zoomed in that whole fucking time? Sorry, guys. The show really reminded me of why I really love doing this. It's not always about making videos and sticking the camera in people's faces. You know, a lot of times it's just enjoying what you're doing. And you don't always have to, you know, see and be seen and, you know, all that crap. So I went back to the roots there yesterday, and it was great. So look forward to more videos, though. I'll start cracking down on making more videos. I just wanted one little opportunity to have a day for myself. All right, guys. Have a great day today, and be sure to stay on the lookout for all the great new videos. All right, guys. This is EXO signing out. Yeah.